Hello everyone and welcome back to a new topic in Microsoft Word 2013 lab number 7. To get started with today's lab, you will need two files. You will need Word lab 7 instructions file. Also you need the Word lab 7 starting file. You should download these two files and open both of them and position them as we usually do for any new lab, one on the right side for instructions, one on the left side, so you give yourself enough room to work on the lab. So I will go ahead and do the same thing. I will open the instructions, I will position it on the right side, and then I will open the starting file and I will position it on the left side. So topics covered in this lab: we will create a title page, we'll learn how to do that. Also, we'll set the margins, we'll insert a table, we'll learn how to insert a page break, and then update paragraphs settings. Then we'll use the find and replace. Also, we'll use footnotes and endnotes, and we will insert bibliography at the end of the document. And that goes side by side with the page break, because before we insert the bibliography, we'll go to the end of the page and then insert a page break, and then have a blank page by itself to insert the bibliography. So are you ready to get started with this lab? All right, good. So to get started with this lab, you need to start with the instructions sections. So in the instructions, it says open Word 7 starting file. We already did that. Save the document as wordlab7.docx. So I will go ahead and click on file, and then after I click on file, I will go ahead and click on save as, and I will click on the folder that we use to save our solutions. If you don't have it, you create it, please. It's a good habit to have a structured folder, as we do for our Microsoft Word labs. And we'll do the same thing when we start working with Microsoft Excel and PowerPoint, so you have all of your files in the right location. So I will change the name of this file to Word Lab 7, and then click on OK. And now I have completed the second item in the instructions. It says check the spelling and grammar and correct the document as needed. So this is something that you will do on your own, but I will go ahead and get you started. You will click on review tab and then click on spelling and grammar. And once you click on spelling and grammar, go through the document and make sure that you correct any errors that you see. For example, here, if I close this one, if I go back here, resume, it says that I need to correct this one, but I'm not going to correct it. You need to do that, please. I will just give you an example here. If I choose the second one here, or do you know what? That's a name. So, and this name, I know that this name is correct. So I will go ahead and ignore. So now, finished. You want the rest of the document? Yes, go ahead and check the rest of the document. Okay. Second one here, ignore it, and then I know this is a name and this is a book I used before. I will go ahead and click on ignore, ignore again, and now I am done with the spelling. Also, you need to go through the document and see if there are any grammar mistakes and try to fix that. But if you look at the very bottom here and look at the no proofing errors, that gives you an indication that you don't have any spelling or grammar errors, which is in this scenario, it will be a document free of errors. So we are done with number 3. Let's go ahead and start with number 4. To complete number 4, it says at the beginning of the document. If you are anywhere inside the document and you need to go to the first line of the document, you press Control Home. Control Home will put you at the first line of your document, or you can click at the beginning of the line once you have the IPM for the insertion point, and then you go to the first character or letter in the first line, and then click, and that will put your IPM or cursor at the beginning of the document. Alright, so now I need to insert a cover page. So to insert a cover page, do I go to the insert page? Yes. And then you click on page, and then it choose cover page. What is the name of the cover page? It's called Filigree. And then once I click on it, I have my cover page inside my document. It will take a minute here, and then if I scroll down, it already inserted the cover page. In the cover page here, it says update the elements. So this cover page, I have some elements and I need to update these elements before I continue. It says here the document title should be teaching online program. So I'll go ahead and click on it, and then I will start typing teaching online program. All right. And then the subtitle should be created by your first name and your last name. If your first name is John and your last name is William, you will type John William, created by colon space John space William. So in my scenario here, I will go ahead and do the same thing, created by colon, and then I will put my first name and my last name. Then you will need to scroll down to complete the elements of this cover page. It says here the date. The date, please make sure that it choose today's date. So basically, if you click on the down arrow here and then it choose today, that will insert today's date. So easy. And then the company name, please make sure that you change the company name to the college name. So it will be Mountain Empire Community College. All right. And then the address, which is the address I gave you in the instructions here, it's 3441 and then a space Mountain Empire Road. And then comma, a big stone gap. And then another comma, that is in Virginia, dot, and then I will put 24219, which is the zip code. So basically, that's what you need to do to complete the cover page. Look, you created a cover page in almost no time. It looks very nice, right? So now let's go ahead and continue with our lab instructions. It says here, add a website source as depicted below. So you look at this image here and make sure that you add a website source. So now I need to add a source. Which tab do I need to go to? So now I'm working with a research paper and I need to update my references. So now looking at my document here, yes, you are right, this tab here, if you click on it and then click on manage sources, you can do that. And once you click on manage sources, you click on new. Or another way to do it, you can go to insert citation and click on add new source, and it will take you direct to the create source. You choose the source, correct source that I'm asking you to create, and then you fill in the information. So I will go ahead and do it the first way, manage sources. This is easier because you can look at it, update it, edit it, delete it, copy it, and so on, and see a sample of how the citation looks like. So I'll go ahead and click on new, and now same thing, right? And then I will choose website. Yes, that's correct. The author, you will need to type Minnesota, and then comma, the university. Actually, what I need to do, I need to fix that, and I will just type the University of Minnesota. So please make sure that you fix that. For some reason, it's just mixed up in the author, University of Minnesota. And then once you finish here, you go down and the name of the web page, it will be www. Actually, you need to add HTTP and then colon, double forward slashes, www.university. Of Minnesota, M-A-N, and then .edu. Then it says here the name of the site or the name of the website, the University of Minnesota, same thing. So you will take this one here and go to the name of the website, the year, you will put 2010, and then the month, you will go ahead and add February, which is 2, and then 4 for the day. The URL, same URL that you added here. This is just to get you practiced, and then in the future you can update this information based on the reference that you are using in your page. So I'll go ahead and click OK, and that will add the bibliography entry as you see it right now. Then it says here insert another source in the item below it here. If I move this a little bit to the left, insert another book source. So I will go ahead and click on new, and this time I will choose book instead of website, which is the first one, and then the author will be Rina, and then m.pal off, right, and then comma Keith, and then Pratt, right? Then you will go to the title and then type Building Online Learning Community. Building Online Learning Community. And then you will go to the year and then add 2007 as you see in the image. So you are just copying the information from the instructions to the actual manage sources section inside your solution. The city is San Diego, and then the publisher is John Willy and Sons, right? Let me fix this here, and then you click on OK. So now you added two of them, and then once you finish, you click on OK again. So let's go ahead and continue with the instructions. So we are progressing. We finished all the way to number 7 now. It says here, insert a bibliography at the end of the document in a separate page. So now, this is the document, your solution. You will press Control End to go to the end of the document, and then you press Control Enter to go to a new page, which is going to give you a page break, as we explained at the very beginning. And once you go to the a new page at the very end of your documents, you will click on bibliography, and then you will insert the bibliography, and that will add the two items that you added right now. Let's say there are some elements here that are not complete. It's a good idea. I need you to complete it and try to go online and search for some of the sources I'm using here and update your bibliography. So this is an additional exercise. And once you update, you will go to manage sources and then add new based on your reading. After you read this document, you go look for more sources, and then once you add them, you click on update citation and bibliography, and that will add any new box that you add to your document. Please keep that in mind. This is very nice feature inside Microsoft Word. You can use that for any paper that you are completing throughout your academic years at the college here, or if you move to another college, or in the business environment in the future. It says here, insert a citation in the first paragraph beside Pal-Off and Pratt. So you'll go to the very beginning of the document, Control Home. Actually, this is the instructions, so I don't need to the beginning. I move to the beginning of the instructions, because the blinking I-beam is inside the instructions. So you need to make sure that you activate your solution and then press Control Home. That will take you to the first page. Now you scroll down, we are done with the title page, and it says here, insert a citation source beside let's say Pratt here. You click here and then take a space and go to references and then insert citation, and then you insert the citation for that publisher, and that's what you get by inserting this citation. All right, so you have a brief citation here, and a comprehensive list of this source is at the very bottom of the page under bibliography. So now you know the difference between adding or inserting a citation and inserting a complete bibliography at the end of the of the documents. Right, so now we are going to cover something that you really like now, which is adding a watermark. Do you know when you go to any business office, sometimes you will see a very light text in the background of the page that has the logo of the business? You can do the same thing in Microsoft Word. Now you are a computer professional and you should be able to do that on your own. So I will go to the My Solution, and then I will go to now. I need to add a watermark. So now, should I go to the page layout, or should I go to the design, or the insert? Which tab do I need to go to access the watermark? Yes, you are right. You have seen it. Under design, you click on watermark, and then since I need to add my own image, these default selections here don't fit my need. So I will go to custom Walmart, and then once I go to custom Walmart, I will make sure that I choose the image. It's coming up, just one second. Select a picture, and then you go to the office clip art and type here collaboration, and then press enter. And then once you press enter, you will get the image I mentioned in the instructions. You click on it and then click on insert, and then click on OK. That will add, you might see it very light, very light. Why is it very light? Because if it has the strong pixels, you should, it will hide the text in the document. So in order to show the text in the document, Microsoft Word, it changes the transparency of the image to be very low, so you can see the text inside your document. So now we are done. Let's to go up a little bit and look at what we have. Look, it looks very nice now, very nice. Now indent the first line of each paragraph by half an inch. So you will go to your document here and then start from the first paragraph, click and drag all the way down, all the way down. But don't select the bibliography. We need to do that for all of the paragraphs inside my documents. And then you go to Home tab, you click on the dialog launcher beside paragraph. And once you go here, you go to a special first line indent, and I need to indent it by half an inch, and then click OK. Look at my paragraphs now. I'm done with this one as well. My document now, it is looking more professional as I finish the instructions that I have right now. All right, now it says here, insert a centered table as depicted in the image below. Where do you put it? You put it after the second paragraph. So this is the first paragraph of my document, right? And this is the second paragraph of my document. So you go to the end of the second paragraph and then press enter. Now, how do you insert a table that looks like that? Okay, now that might take us a while to finish, but it's very important to learn how to modify and format tables in Microsoft Word. So I need to insert a table. So which tab do I need to go to? Yes, you're right. I will go to the insert tab and then I will go to table. Now, I will insert two columns. Let's start to buy two columns and one row. All right, and then I will start typing. So what is the first text here? It says method. So you will type method and then tab. When you press tab, it takes you to the next cell. So percent, and then if I press shift tab, it will take you to the cell, the previous cell. Tab again, it will take you to the next cell. All right, now I need one more row. So, right, tab again, it will create a row, and then you type discussion board, and then tab again, you type the percent, which is 10%. Tab again, journal, right, and then tab again, you type 5%, and then tab social networks. And then tab one more time, and then type 5%. All right, so now it looks a little bit like the one I have here, but not, I'm not there yet. Look at the text. The text is centered dead in the middle. So now I need to insert a row before. So if I go here, and then do you see this plus sign? I will click on this plus sign. Now I get a blank row, but it is not in the correct location. So can I do that? Can I select this whole row and then go to the layout, all right, and then insert. I need to insert let me make this bigger so you can see all of the option. Insert a column. Okay, this is a column. I already selected the entire column, all right. This is, this whole thing here is a column. So I selected my column. I will go to insert. I need to insert what? Insert a row or a column. So now this is for column or row. It shows you here. It shows you. This is for rows. Now I need to insert a column that goes left. Perfect. So now I inserted a column that goes left. So the way I inserted the column here was good, but I don't need the column here. So I need to select this entire column. Look at my cursor. Until you see the black arrow, you click, and then you go to layout tab. Make sure that layout is open, and then you go to delete, and then you delete columns. Perfect. So now I have my three columns as you see in the instructions. So I will go ahead and drag that here. Okay, now student success. So I will go here and type student success. And the text here is horizontal, but the text in the instruction is vertical. Please everyone make sure that this is an image. If you copy this image and paste it here, you will get zero for the entire lab. So please don't do that. I need you to work on the actual lab and finish it step by step. So now I need to make all of these cells as one single cell. How can I do that? I will go to the layout here, and then I will click on merge cells, right? Perfect. So once you go to merge cells, now let me maximize here so you can see the options I have. Do you see under alignments? Make sure that the layout tab is select, and then look at under alignments. It choose text direction here, and that will give you the format that we need for the lab as you see it here. So I'll go ahead and change the size of this table. Now I need to center it. You click on the table here. Do you see this icon here? This will select the entire table. And then you go to the home tab, and then it choose center, and that will center the table exactly in the middle. All right, so now look at percent, look at method, look at student success. They are shifted all the way up. I need them to display exactly as you see them here. All right, so I will go ahead and click, select the entire table, and then go to layout, and then I will click on auto fit, and then I will choose auto fit contents. So now I'm getting closer to completing this lab. Then I will go to the design tab, and then it choose the design that looks like my table here. So I choose the design. What is the name of this design? It is called Great Table 5 Dark Accent 4, right? So now my table is not centered anymore. So to center it, you go to home, make sure it is selected. You click on center, and now you have it centered one more time. Okay, look at this table. Do you see the alternate rows style here? To make sure that you have a white background as you see it here, you go to the layout tab, all right, or actually the design tab, and then click on uncheck banded rows, all right. So that gives you, but it doesn't give you a white background. To get a white, okay, well, do you know what the border of this table is does not match the border of this table. The border of this table is yellow. I'm so glad this is happening. So when you make this mistake, you know that you need to match this table exactly to look like it. So you select the entire table, look for a design that matches what I have here. So now that looks more like this one, but I will have to change the color for the headers. And then I will go to home, and then I will center it. Then I will change the font. I will use the text effect here to this font, which is called Fill Gray 25 Background to Inner Shadow. Now, I will also apply the same font to the title of my table. I need to make sure that the background of this, the fill background to be black. Now I'm getting closer, and the fill background for this one is going to, let me make sure that I select the actual background, and then I will choose dark navy here. Does that look like it? What about this one here? Okay, if you choose dark blue, that would be fine. Looking at the table here, and then let me make this text a little bit bigger. So I will make it bigger. I know this table by itself is a lot of work, but you will learn if you do this or you complete this table. Now I need to make the size of my student success to be bigger. Now I'm getting closer. Look at the discussion board and the journal and social networks. They are bold, right? So I need to apply the bold effect. Now, what else can I do? Look at student success here and look at student success here. Does it look good to you? It's not the same. It doesn't look the same. You will lose points if you don't get it completely correct, as you see in the table. So I will select student success, and then I will go to the paragraph. Then I will make sure that I don't have any indentation, I don't have any spacing after the paragraph, and then I will choose single space and then choose OK. Now look at student success, much better now, right? Much better. Do the same thing for methods. So you go to paragraph, remove the space after, and then make sure that you have single, and then click OK. Now go ahead and click on layout and make sure that let me maximize this so you can see all of the alignments. So in table you have different alignments, right? So now for student success you do the same thing. Now it looks great. So now let's go ahead and take this one to the left side and look at both of them here. Do they look the same to you? They look the same, except this shadow here is a little bit darker, but that's fine. You can choose dark blue for the color, the background color for the table header. So I guess what you can do, you can use, do you see this box here? If you click and drag, you can change the actual look. You can change the size of the entire table. You keep doing that until you make it look professionally. So this is a practice more than a lab, a practice for you to get your table correct inside your documents. So it says here, find the first cooperation word in the documents. So how do you find the first cooperation word? First, you click inside the solution, press Control Home to go to the first line, and then go to Home tab, click on Editing, and then it choose Find, or you can press Control F on the keyboard, and then I need to search for cooperation, right? And then once I look, once you type cooperation, it will show you all of the instances of cooperation. So find the first cooperation word in the document, which is here in the first line, then add a footnote beside it that is entitled Working Together. So you click beside cooperation here, so now I don't need this anymore because I know where is the location of cooperation. And then I will go to preferences, and then I will click on insert footnote, and the title or the text of this footnote will be working together, right? And once you are done, you click anywhere inside your document. So a footnote is very nice because someone can go here and then look at what you really mean by cooperation, right? Find all instances of DB, make sure that you match the case and replace it by discussion board. So you go inside your documents and you go to the home tab, click on editing, and then click on replace. So you need to replace DB uppercase by discussion board, right? But make sure you click on more and then choose match case, and then once you are done, you click replace. It replaced the first one. Replace again. It replaced the second one. Or you can replace all, and it will tell you here that there were some replacement in the documents. So now I will go ahead. I'm done. I will close this one. It says here save and upload the file Word Lab 7 via Blackboard. So you save that and then upload it to Blackboard. So if you look, if we go back here and then look at the solution, look at the solution here, that's how your research paper should look like. Do you see how it looks now? It looks much better, right? Please, everyone, make sure that your document looks like that. And if you'd like to add more bibliography, as I mentioned, this is optional. But if you have it the way it looks like now, that would be perfect. Thank you, everyone, for watching, and I will see you in future videos. Bye bye.